Mm-mm.
Say hi to the people. Say hi to the people.
Okay. I'm gonna let you go live your life, baby. Okay, go ahead.
If you are new here, welcome to my channel. It's your girl at Miss Dosula Ogola. Make sure you hit that subscribe button. Thank you for subscribing. So in this video, nataka tu kuongea juu ya anxiety. You know, I was accused of not speaking Kiswahili a lot, but nataka kuongea juu ya anxiety and the fact that a lot of people are dealing and they're quiet about it and they're not talking about it because sometimes no one is out there validating their feelings and experiences.
The first time I was aware I was dealing with anxiety was in 2020 when the pandemic hit.
I know exactly when, in February. February, March, that's when I knew, yo, yeah, kunoma, silali, sikuli, pumui. I sweat too, even when people are not sweating, I'm like, hey, guys, unasikia joto? People look at you like, bro, why are you sweating like that? The moment that I knew it was really bad was when I couldn't sleep. And I'd wake up in the middle of the night scared or terrified about something. And this something that I'm terrified or scared about has not happened yet. And it does not exist even sometimes. That's when I knew shit just got real. I'm dealing. What was happening at that time was just the transitions, working from home. We didn't know whether we are losing jobs or keeping jobs, you know, something like that. Feeling like the world is ending and I have not gotten married. I do not have children. What is my legacy? You know, what will people say about Dosula Ogola, honey? What will they say? What will the world? You know, I'm like, God, does it just end like this? So that's why I was actually very, very much so anxious. If you a point, I had to speak to someone, and I was like, sasa easy coins kidogo niko nazo. Let me use them to just at least get someone for a month. It's two sessions of therapy to just talk to someone and share with them my weird, sometimes normal, sometimes irrational thoughts, and help, you know, to see how that helps me. And I got a therapist, and even though tukaanza kazi kuongea, kuongea tu about my thoughts, kuongea about my feelings, kuongea about my worries, my issues. A therapist helped me a lot just to see, you know what, Dosula, it's not all ending, you know. But you're still here, honey. Uko hapa bado. So you got this, honey. I started therapy, I think, November, December, there. That's when I started, and it was really good and it was working out really well, and I was enjoying it and I was enjoying the growth, and my anxiety was shukain, yeah, kidogo. So come January, of course, nika travel. I traveled in January. I went home to just rest, and I realized that my anxiety levels were really, really low, especially because of change of environment. One, kwenda Ocha, girl, the rest, the zen, the peace, the nice air. Like, my anxiety levels literally chini. So when I came back to Nairobi later on in Jan, I went and spoke to the therapist, and I told her, honestly, when I was at home, Ocha, like, I never got any anxiety attack, panic attacks. I never sweated in the middle of the night or woke up in the middle of the night feeling like, whoo, things are, you know, like the world is just about to end and all of that. So when I told her that, what she told me was, notice where you're calm, notice where you're at peace, notice where you're not getting these anxiety attacks, and try to recreate those experiences here in Nairobi. So recreation of those experiences would be going to Karura, for example. So now I'm getting into things that I've been doing to help me deal with anxious thoughts. The anxiety, honey, if you're dealing, if you know what I'm talking about, honey, like, let me know in the comment section so that you can let me know that I'm not alone, and we can let other people know that they are not alone, man. Like, these issues, we just need to know that we are not alone. That's it. So aliniambia to try and recreate those environments here in Nairobi. So for me, nikajua, nature really helps me chill, it helps me relax, you know, the clean air and all of that. And I have my other coping mechanisms that I used to implement. The first one was, especially in the middle of the night, if I just wake up and I feel like, oh my gosh, what is going on, I keep a rubber band on my hand. Let me show you. Yeah, normally you'll just see me with a rubber band on my hand, and what I do when I wake up in the middle of the night, I just flick it like that, and then so after I've flicked it, that campaign, it reminds me, guy, Dosula, you are still here and you're still alive and everything is okay. So in the middle of the night, I just flick it and it calms me down. It's like, whew, you can breathe, take deep breaths in, deep breaths out.
The other thing that I really like to do when I get anxious is just go to the fridge and get some ice, and I just put it on my hand and I touch it. The coolness of the ice just reminds me that I'm still here, everything is okay, and it just brings me back to my reality.
One that I really, really love and enjoy is going for walks in the morning. Like, when I go for those walks in the morning and the sun just hits my body, I just feel like, girl, you're here, you're alive, and it actually feels really good to be alive, you know, and to enjoy the sun. And it just reminds me that, you know, you're still here, God is still here, the sun is still here, it's gonna rise, it's gonna set. We're doing good, we're doing great. That's another strategy, like just going for walks and feeling the sun. And also just those walks and seeing people living their lives and going about their business also just reminds me that, you know what, you're good. Everything is good. People are leaving and life is actually moving on and all of that good stuff. So that's another one. The other thing that I do is working out. Those ones, even by the way, like when I'm feeling like, yo, it's been a hard day, workout. When you go and you work it out, you move your body, the feeling during the workout might not be the best, let me warn you, yeah. But after the workout, I just feel, when I get home, I'm just busting a move. I just feel really good and I'm like, wow, that really has helped me a lot. So I don't know, those are some of the few tips that I use to help me relax. And because I'm trying to make this video as short as possible, so my question to you is this: Do you deal with anxiety, anxious thoughts, anxious feelings, and have you experienced it, and how do you deal with it? You know, how do you deal with it, honey? How do you deal with it? How do you deal with it? Share so that I know that I'm not alone and someone else can know that they're not alone, and we can validate your experience and your feelings together. Okay, thank you for watching this video. It's your girl at Miss Drusilla Ogolo. Make sure you hit that subscribe button and make sure you share this video with someone who will be inspired, encouraged, motivated, you know, and all of that good stuff.